Welcome to this 1-2-3 session about OCSng and iTop integration. Let's see together how to manage your infrastructure information efficiently. The integration of OCSng with iTop through iTop Data Collector for OCSng helps you retrieve and display in iTop only the data you need. The automated collection of assets and software from OCSng is easier, faster, improve performance and makes it easier for IT administrators to manage the infrastructure because they get all the information at a glance directly in iTop. To make it work properly, you will first need running instances of iTop and OCSng. Then, you need to install the extension data model for OCSng, which adds two classes for assets and software categories and new fields in iTop. This extension also provides a direct link between iTop and OCSng to switch easily between each application. Finally, you will use iTop Data Collector for OCSng, which automatically filters and collects data from OCSng. Now, let's discover together how it works. All the elements of your infrastructure, such as devices, hardware, software, network information, are identified and described in details in OCSng. OCSng dashboard references all assets. As an example, you can see here the list of computers. Data Collector for OCS collects and synchronizes devices information such as PC, server, virtual machine, mobile phone, printers, or software information. This synchronization is based on asset and software categories configured both in OCSng and Data Collector. Assets are linked to the different categories in OCSng, like this computer belonging to PC notebook category. All assets categorized are pushed by the Data Collector to iTop. Devices are automatically added as configuration items in iTop CMDB within the correct class and associated with their software information. The synchronization information is displayed in iTop top bar menu, and a direct link makes it easy to switch to the corresponding asset in OCSng. Now let's deep dive into the setup. Before starting, you have first to configure the Data Collector connection with OCS and iTops and set the list of data and categories synchronization. Then, add the extension data model for OCS inventory, which helps you create new classes in iTop for OCS assets and software. In OCSng, you identify devices and create asset categories. Do the same with software. Activate collectors categories only and run it. You should automatically retrieve active categories data from OCSng and push them to iTop. Next step is to map those categories with iTop classes. OCS asset and software categories elements are displayed in iTop after the first synchronization. But a target class needs to be mapped to a category. To do so, edit the category in iTop and define the correct target class. Once it is done, you just need to set the last parameters, use assets categories and use software categories to yes, and activate the collector. Your collector is now ready to use and will automatically synchronize your data from OCSng. You want to know more about it? Let's dig into step-by-step synchronization now. Before collecting data from OCS, iTop Data Collector gets the synchronization get data source, checks its fields, and update or create new data source if needed. Then, asset categories are selected an SQL request to OCSng created based on the required categories. Assets data is retrieved from a CS by the data collector, which creates CSV file with collected data and send them to iTop for asset update. The process of data synchro is more or less the same for software, beside the fact that iTop gets software or software categories. You can read the official collector documentation for more details. And thank you for watching!